these stories that have been percolating about Congresswoman Nancy Mace, because I have some conspiratorial thoughts about this. I'll share those thoughts after I give you the detail about the story. So, new reporting by the Daily Beast alleges that turnover among Congresswoman Nancy Mace's DC staff is so high that literally the entirety of her office has changed since November 1st of 2023. Completely new staffers. Now, that's 9 staffers in the span of 3 months, with all but one of them leaving on their own accord. One of them was fired, that lone exception was let go. We don't know the details about why that individual was let go, but nonetheless, Capitol Police were called on him by his successor when he tried to return his keys. Now, as for the other 8, their reason for leaving was due to a toxic workplace. And so they spoke to the Daily Beast on condition of anonymity, which I think is kind of a cowardly thing to do, right? If you're gonna make some serious allegations about a toxic work environment, don't do it anonymously. Like, have the courage to speak your truth publicly while revealing your name. But anyway, the member was abusive, one former senior staffer said, specifically pointing to the frequency with which Mace would communicate with her staff, either over text, Signal, or monday.com, which sounds like a satanic app that everyone should avoid, an unauthorized software system Mace uses in her office. Monday.com. Why does this exist? It's like, let's think of the day of the week that everyone hates the most. Name our app that, and then have it be like a workplace messaging thing that's gonna drive people crazy. Anyway, that's not important to the story. It's just, it really triggered me, I guess. The former staffer also told the Daily Beast that Mace would constantly use the software to micromanage the office all day and into the night slash early morning. Whether Mace needed something from her staff, they had to reply within 8 minutes. Within 8 minutes, that's what they're alleging. A staffer also clarified that this was an actual rule. One senior staffer also recalled how Mace called them close to midnight on Christmas Eve, demanding to know why she wasn't getting on television more during the holiday week. So there are more details about these allegations. I've pretty much read you the worst of it. Is this a campaign by like the, I don't know, like the Kevin McCarthy wing of the Republican Party to try to destroy her political career? Because this is now like the second or third piece that's been written about how awful she was to her staff. And look, I would be annoyed by these rules. Like, if I had a boss who said, you need to respond to me in 8 minutes, even if I'm contacting you near midnight on Christmas Eve, I'd be annoyed by that. But is that really all they've got? And why do these stories keep coming out? There's something strange and fishy about these stories, I think. What do you think, Cenk?
Yeah, okay, so Anna, there you go. So I think you're totally right to be skeptical about these stories. And both things can be true at the same time, which is that the story can be true and a hatchet job to assassinate her character anyway. So, and I think that a lot of Republicans hold or politics, ooh, Democrats do it too, don't get me wrong. They hold stuff in their back pocket until they need it, right? And so they, like, sometimes the most common attack against someone, usually a male, is some sort of sexual impropriety if they want to do a character assassination. The second most common is toxic workplace. And in fact, for women, it's the most common.
If you wanna
attack a woman in politics, just throw a toxic workplace charge at her, right? And so I've now seen it at least half a dozen times to prominent women. They just did it to Marianne Williamson earlier in this cycle, etc. Right? So, and she, you're right. She's one of the guys, one of the people who voted against McCarthy and did that whole drama, right? One of the 8. And who's one of the other 8? Matt Gaetz. And all of a sudden, sexual impropriety charges resurface.
Yes, Cenk. Right? Yes, thank you for reminding me of that. That's so true.
Right. Now, it doesn't mean that they didn't do it.
Right.
But you do have to, and I said this, and we are, look, man, we're the only people trying to do actual news here. We do it in a nonpartisan way. So I thought that the treatment of the Harvard and Penn dean in that congressional hearing about protesters, et cetera, was unfair. And it was largely a character assassination. I can't stand Nancy Mace or Matt Gaetz, but I think that these are also character assassinations, right? So now, as to whether it's true or not, well, you need context, right? So just because Daily Beast writes about it, I mean, Daily Beast is where you go to do character assassinations. So that means nothing that they wrote about it, right? Mm-hmm. And so, well, for example, when at one point they tried it against me, but it was in terms of toxic workplace, but it was hilarious. There's like one person out of hundreds and hundreds of people that worked here, right? And people stay here 15, 20 years. So it's pretty good example of a place that's a really great place to work, right? Mm-hmm. In the case of Nancy Mace, her entire staff cleared out in 3 months. So was it toxic? Yeah, it was probably toxic. But some of the charges are absurd.
Right, okay. Can I jump in now, Cenk? Because listen, who among us hasn't existed in a work environment where there's one overzealous person in management who's like breathing down your neck too much? Everyone's experienced that. So yes, I mean, you should stand up for yourself and you should say, listen, I have my boundaries and I'm not gonna talk to you at like 9 p.m. on a Friday night, kick rocks. And I know that not everyone is comfortable doing that because there might be retaliation, but I just feel like the claims against her, it just seems like she wanted press, she wanted to appear on television, she wanted her team to put out press releases regularly. She wanted to stay in the news and she was constantly contacting them and they were annoyed by that. I don't know if that really crosses the line into a toxic work environment. When I think of toxic work environment, I think of an employer or a manager who's like throwing things at you or retaliates against you by refusing to give you a promotion for a dumb reason, right? Like that kind of stuff. In this case, it's like, all right, she's a little overzealous and she wants us to respond right away. I feel like that's common and yeah, it's unacceptable and you can maybe find ways around it. I don't know if this is like the worst offense. You get what I'm saying?
100%. So look, there's perfectly bad. So the 8-minute rule is stupid. The way she hounds her staff is not great. The way she tried to get a former staffer arrested, not great. The turnover is record breaking. Okay, but on the other hand, some of the complaints are preposterous. So she wants to be on TV more. That means she's actually working. I mean, yeah, you could say that's for her own fame, et cetera, but remember, most of the members of Congress hide in a cave. They never do anything, right? And then when I read this second to last paragraph in the Daily Beast article, Mace also held her staff to the standard of passing 10 bills on the House floor every year, which would be an incredible clip for a benchmark, a backbench member, and filing 25 new bills. Wait, why is that a bad thing?
I know.
So she wanted her staff to work hard to introduce bills. Now, I would probably disagree with all those bills because she's a right-wing Republican, but wanting your staff to write bills is great. That's like the best thing I've ever heard about a United States congressperson. I wish everybody would do that. And so that's somehow toxic? Nah, it is a hatchet job, definite hatchet job. Okay. And I'm going to read one last thing because it gives you a sense of how unfair it is because this applies to every single person in Congress, but it is a good insight from a congressional staffer as to how these politicians actually are. The former staffer said, quote, she says nothing publicly without her consultants or senior staffers telling her to, but takes credit for everything. She's a walking teleprompter. Okay. Number one, she's a politician. Of course, she takes credit for everything.
Yes, exactly.
All right. Secondly, this is what I've been telling you guys for 20 years now. These people in Congress are all robots. They don't say anything unless a consultant feeds them talking points. They have no mind of their own. This is just the Republicans outing themselves just to be able to take out Nancy Mace on behalf of, some Republican leadership.
Thanks for watching. If you become a member, you get to watch all this ad-free, except for, of course, this ad. Still, hit the join button below.